The first tour I ever seen, I want to say I was either 13 or 14 years old. My mom okayed for me and took me to see Judas Priest on Defenders of the Faith tour. I remember right before the tour, I got freaking chicken pox, of all things, you know. But luckily, it was towards the end of the chicken pox. But I did go to the freaking show with, you know, red dots all over my face like an idiot. But there was no way in hell that I was missing Judas Priest. Well, it was Judas Priest and Great White, but I didn't know who Great White was, and I wasn't that into that kind of. They were a little bit too light for me. But anyway, it was an amazing experience. I just remember how magical it was to watch a band that I was into so much, you know, play live, and just the, I couldn't believe that I was actually in the same room with these, what I consider, and I still consider, I guess, gods of metal, you know. So it was a really amazing experience, and that tour was really great. They had the big Metallion guy from the record cover on there and stuff, and lots of fire and stuff like that. But one of the, well, besides the fact of I was appreciative that my mom took me to the show, because there's no way she's letting me go at 14 to Madison Square Garden to see Judas Priest, you know, when I was 14 or whatever. But I was appreciated that a lot. But also another great moment of the show was that was the infamous show where people started tearing out the seats in Madison Square Garden and throwing them on stage. And it got to be so brutal by the time they were doing their encore, the stage was full of cushions throughout from the fucking stadium. And I couldn't imagine what my mom was thinking. I mean, she was pretty cool. She wasn't a metalhead. She was more of a 50s and 60s kind of rock music, pop music fan. They were throwing all these cushions on stage, and it was getting to the point where the guys in the band were like bouncing on the cushions on stage, and they couldn't set off like their pyros and stuff like that at the end of the concert because of fire hazard. And it was really cool to be there and witness history like that, because I was reading the K.K. Downing book recently, and he talked about that show, how they got banned from ever playing Madison Square Garden again. And it was just kind of fun to think that my first show was such a, you know, kind of a hellraiser of a show, you know, where, you know, Judas Priest actually got banned from the venue because the fans were just too crazy. But, I mean, at that time in 84, Judas Priest were pretty much on top of their game, so it was a phenomenal show. And on another thing too is I was such a fanatic that before the tour I made sure I bought every Judas Priest album, listened to every song and every album, made sure I knew as many of the lyrics as I possibly could. I told myself I'm not gonna go to the show and they're not gonna play any song that I don't know. I told myself at 14 I wasn't gonna be that poser at the show that's just like, well, what song is this? It's like, no, I was gonna be like, yes, I know everyone, you know. It just was like almost like a metal ego thing I had at the time, where I just had to know that, you know, I was gonna go there and I was gonna know as much about Judas Priest as I could. And it's a different world back then. There wasn't an internet or anything like that, so everything you had to know was from magazines and records, just by listening to it, or rare interview things you'd find here or there, you know, like rare video interviews. It'd be almost impossible back then to find that stuff.